Hey guys, it's a Proud Cat Lover, and this is the second part to my insect collection. I'm also going to be replacing my mothballs this month. And what mothballs do is they keep carpet beetle larvae from getting into my collections and eating on my bugs. It's kind of a general maintenance that you have to do when you have insect collections. Like every 1 to 2 months you have to go through and replace the old moth packets. See, like all the moth crystals have evaporated. And you replace them with new packets. Like I got these 4 packs here for $14 at Walmart, and this is half the bag, so it gives you an idea of how much it comes with. It normally is about this full, and normally you don't have to change them, but maybe like once every 1 to 2 months depending on how quickly they evaporate. So anyway, I'll be also showing you the insects. So this is a box I have where all these I purchased online. My most impressive one in here, of course, is this Atlas moth, or Atlas atticus. And it's in the family of silk moths, so it means it does not have a mouth part, kind of like the Luna moth I talked about the other day. And this one also is in the, it's up there with the biggest moths in the world. So yeah, that's what this guy looks like. He has a 10-inch wingspan, like literally about as long as my hand. So he's a big guy. They're both males, but this one's a little smaller. He has a six inch wingspan. So anyway, that is this box here. Okay, so here is my second box, and this I also bought all of these as well. The only ones you can find in the United States, I believe, is this one here, which is a toe biter. I believe this one here, which is sadly, it targets like trees. I can't remember if it's like ash trees or not, but as a beetle larvae, this one actually bores into trees and it's damaging to the trees. I also believe, I think one of these two also can be found in some parts of the United States, but most of the other ones are from other countries. My most impressive one being this one here that I absolutely love because it's gorgeous. I believe this one is from Madagascar, and like I said, of course, I bought these online. So then I'll real quick replace the moth crystals in here. So this box here has a few random things in it. It's got mainly dragonflies. We have an underwing moth and a sphinx moth that didn't come out of its cocoon right. So I had kept it just because it just, he's sad. He's got like his proboscis all twisted up. He's got parts of the cocoon on him still. So yeah, he was not in very good condition. So I just ended up keeping him. And I'll show you real quick. This is what, like the leftovers of when the carpet beetles get in here and eat all my bugs, like that's a leftover, and then that's like a shed right there from one of them. They're not very big, as you can see, and normally I try to check over my insects sometimes when I see those powders just to make sure we haven't got any in the box, which I don't see any on this guy. But yeah, they'll eat on ones that are long dead, and they'll eat them to a crumble, and the only thing that will be left of the bug is a powder pile. So that's this box. Okay, so in this box, and my phone's doing something weird, there we go. Here's a really key example of what I was just talking about. This is a damselfly I had that became a victim of the carpet beetle larvae, and you can see they ate two of the wings and a few legs. So this poor guy, he's just looking sad, like when I blow on him. The wing moves around and everything. It's not even attached all the way. I haven't messed with him just mainly because there's nothing I can really do for the poor thing. But yeah, that is this box here. And all these from this box on out and the other one are all from here in Kansas that I caught. So I'll show you these. I won't take too long to show you to them just because I have a bunch of boxes. And if there's any insects that you guys see, you can put the time log, like down when you're watching and you see the time, you can take that time and put it in the comments if you have a question on a specific bug and like what it is or something. I'll be happy to answer any of your questions about these insects because I enjoy insects immensely. So anyway, that is this box. Okay, so this box is all wasps, bees, velvet ants, anything like that. And I'll show you from this corner and I'll show you the different ones. I used to not like wasps very much, but after I really started collecting like beetles and everything, started really expanding my horizons on what I really liked, because I used to only collect butterflies and dragonflies and stuff, but then I started really thinking the wasps were cool looking, especially any of the Achumen or Ichimon, however you want to pronounce them. These wasps here are really cool looking. I have one in another box that has an optivisor or an ovipositor. People say it differently. And it's for laying eggs, and it's huge. Like, it's literally about this long, which is about 3 inches. This here is a cicada killer, which you'll see cicadas in my collection a little bit further on. And it will actually catch them. It digs a nest in the ground for its babies, and it takes the cicadas to the babies to eat. So, and these guys, the stinger is so long that you have to actually have it surgically removed half the time because it has barbs on the end like a fish hook, so once it goes in, it's hard to remove it. So yeah, it's painful, I've heard. I've never been stung before, but I'll show you again some of the little wasps. We've got some cedar sawflies. That's what this guy here is, right here. They attack mainly cedar trees, and then there's also this one here. They're pretty cool looking. So that is that box. Okay, so in this one we have grasshoppers, katydids, crickets, and... oh, I think that's everything. Grasshoppers, crickets, and katydids. So katydids are these guys here that look like leaves. We have different ones, as you can see. These three here are different. This one here is a sword-bearing katydid, and the females will have a really long ovipositor here for laying eggs. This one here is, and I actually can't remember his name, but this one here, it's really cool because he has very long legs, like 2 inches. Look at that. And then this one here is cool because, and the pigment is starting to fade because it's been dead for a long time, but you can see here that its wings look like leaf veins. Isn't that cool? It's crazy. So that's what that guy looks like. And then these here are very colorful grasshoppers, the hind wings. I've seen some that are yellow, but I don't have any in my collection that have spread wings or anyway. And over here, we have some of these guys. And this is a tree cricket right here. And they normally are on plants when they're like pollinating the flowers and everything. We have a field cricket that's right there. This is also a tree cricket, but it's a different kind. As you can see here, that one's wings are a lot different than this one. And that is this box. Okay, so in this box we have beetles. And I'll show you some of them. This one here is an eyed click beetle, and they're pretty cool. You can probably hear Rose in the background. She is meowing because she wants in. But she can't come in because she'll try to jump up here. And you can see we've had some casualties in the past that have been eaten on because there's powder sitting there. I'll have to show you my twice-stabbed lady beetle. It's pretty cool looking. Because most people, when they think of lady beetles or ladybugs, they think, you know, down here, orange with black spots, you know, or this one here. I'll show you these little guys over here. They're tiny. But I'll show you. This here is a twice-stabbed lady beetle. This black one here. And they call it that because it's black with two spots that are red. And it looks like it's been stabbed twice. So that's that guy. So, this is that box. Alright guys, so this box only has owlflies, antlions, and a couple brown lace wings in them, but I'll show them to you anyway. And these guys are what my owlfly should have looked like that was hatching, but he did not live. Here's what owlflies look like. And I don't know if it's gender is the reason this one has brown spots, but I caught it just in case. That's why. Here is an antlion. And then we have the two brown lace wings here. That's what they look like. The green lace wings, which you'll see, you know, in a couple boxes here that are coming up. The green lace wings actually look a lot like those tree crickets. They have flat laying wings, as where the brown lace wings have them sticking up. So it's very interesting. But that is this box. Okay guys, so this is one of my moth boxes, and a lot of the insects in here are very old. A few of them I raised myself, but most of them I caught. Like this one here, I actually raised, and I have never seen any since. I believe I have two of them, and I released the rest of them, just because I was wanting to keep two, just in case one didn't pin correctly. But I'll show you a few of these, and this is my only bagworm moth. So if you guys have ever seen bagworm hanging from like evergreen trees and stuff, this is what the male looks like. The female will actually stay a caterpillar forever. and she'll just stay in her bag for her entire life. But the male actually comes and turns into a moth, so that's what he looks like, even though he's quite ugly. But when I was in 4-H, I was very well known for doing a decent job of pinning my moths and butterflies compared to other people in the group. These are old, so they aren't as impressive looking as my others, because as I got older and did it more often, I progressed in making them look way better, a lot more attractive, more lifelike. But like these here, I actually raised from caterpillars. And then we have a couple yellowscape collared moths or something like that. I know I'm not getting that name right, but I have one of each. I have an orange collared and a yellow collared. And it pretty much, they're the same moth, they just have different collars. When I was younger, I pretty much collected anything that was a different color, even if it was the same type of moth. A few that I'll show you that are my favorites. Let's see, where did the little guy go? This one is really cool. And then this one here has really neat patterns. Actually, I don't know if it was that one. Let me see. Yeah, if you notice, there's really small black spots. But yeah, moths fascinate me. So that is the second box. Okay, guys, so here's another beetle box, except it's got a viceroy butterfly in it, just because I ran out of room in my butterfly boxes, so it got stuck in here. But this has a little bit more of my bigger and really tiny beetles. It has my smallest beetle in my collection, which is this one here. And it's about the size of if you took a pin and made a dot on a piece of paper. That's about how big it is. Like, here's my finger compared to that little beetle. So he's even smaller than the pinhead, so he's very tiny. And I'll show you, we've got some blister beetles here, which you don't want to get bit by these guys or get any of the oil on your skin. It will cause you to get blisters. Got a longhorn beetle here. Got a milkweed longhorn, which is this guy here. And we'll look at some of these. And this one here is the male and this is the female. And I can't remember the name of these two, but they normally come out in the fall and they like to live, or not live, they like to rest on trees. You can see we also had a casualty here at one time. And in here there are a few doubles just because some stuff I catch and then I don't realize that I actually have it. And in here we have this interesting shaped beetle that's right there. This one here is interesting shaped. Then we have this one here that's green. He's cool looking. But yeah, I really love longhorn beetles. Like, you'll see a lot of longhorn beetles that I own just because I love longhorns. They're so pretty. We have some more over here. And as I got older and did entomology more, I started to spread the mandibles like I did with this beetle here so that they look more lifelike. And it's a lot of fun making them look real. And I'll show you, this beetle here is really cool. He's also a longhorn beetle. And a friend of mine that's going to college for entomology, it's her fourth year that she's going, so she should be like graduating this year, which is cool. She actually has never seen these before. And so I told her that I could give one to her if I had a double, which I'm not sure if I do or not, but there's one, so we'll keep track. But there's a beetle in here, and I'll show you them. And there was a small colony that lived in my backyard for a while. Like, every year they'd be there on this one tree to breed. But then someone cut the tree down, so they left. But they're really cool, and I caught a decent amount of them. Each one is a different pattern, and they're amazing. I can't remember if they're like a type of leaf miner beetle, but that's a couple of them. And I have one over here. And you can see that one is completely different in pattern from the last one I just showed you. Let's see, the other one is right here. There's a couple that are down here. This one and this one. And they are similar looking to the other ones, but the patterns are still different. And yeah, those ones are really cool. I don't know why, but I just love the black and yellow pattern because it really is vivid. So there is that box. Okay, guys, so this is my flies box, and this has all my, like, robber flies, horse flies, crane flies, mosquitoes, everything is in this box. Bottle flies, all that stuff. So these are a couple of my crane flies. My mom used to call these daddy mosquitoes because they look like giant mosquitoes, but I promise you they're completely harmless. You can hold them, touch them, just gotta be careful because these legs are extremely delicate. And here's another one that I have. We have a robber fly here, and these actually will be mainly found in meadows, open fields, pastures, and they actually will hunt other insects that are either their size or a little bit bigger, and they'll catch them, and they will actually suck out their insides with this mouth part here. Let me get this to focus. Apparently you can't. So yeah, that's what they look like on the front, and pardon the noise in the background because the air conditioner just kicked on. So I'll show you a few flower flies, which are these guys here, the little yellow and black ones. We have a bottle fly here, which is this one here. We have another robber fly, which is this guy. Then here's another robber fly. And that's also a robber fly. I have a lot of robber flies. And then this is another flower fly right here. And then I'll show you. This one here is my smallest fly in my collection. And I believe it is a type of husk fly is what they're called. So anyway, that is that. Oh yeah, I'll show you this really cool one time. I caught it a couple years ago and I thought it was the coolest looking fly because it's got these feathery attachments to its hind legs. And then its wings are really pretty, but that's what that one looks like. He's pretty awesome looking. He's my most colorful fly that I have aside from the green ones. So anyway, that is this box. Okay, so we're on to the last box on the, because I have two columns. I think I have like 24 of these boxes, but this is the last one on the first column, and this is just a few more dragonflies. We've got a Halloween pennant. We've got a female six-spotted Donner Dasher? Oh, I can never remember. There's so many names, but it's a six-spotted dragonfly, pretty much. This is a... Oh my gosh. I already forgot the name of it. It's terrible. Whenever I go to make these videos, the name just leaves me, and I know them because I see them all the time. But they're huge. Like, they're a very big dragonfly. They're quite large. That's what he looks like. Stick him back in there. But, yeah, so this is the last box. Like I said, on the right side, we have a little tiny damselfly. He's a little guy, as you can see here. And damselflies are very hard to spread their wings without breaking them off, as you'd seen a while ago, how that one's wing was very delicate and it was blown around because it had been eaten on. So you can imagine it's extremely hard to pin them without tearing them. So if you can do it, good job to you. But here is that box. Okay guys, so this one is a moth box. It's the first one on the left column that I have. And I'll show you a few, and as you can see in the past I've had some casualties due to carpet beetle larvae. I'll show you a few of these. My more interesting ones are in here. Like, I love tiny moths. They're amazing. Like, the pattern that is on these moths is just so cool. And like, this one here even has like pink. You can't really tell very well, but there's pink on that one. And then underwing moths are amazing. This here is a sphinx moth, the only one I've ever seen, and this one I found dead, and it is gorgeous. I just love the vibrant pink on it. We have these ones over here. I actually raised this one. And then I love these because when they're sitting up against a tree, they blend in completely. Like, I have a picture I can put in here somewhere that I took. When I found one, and I just left it because I already had one, of course, but look at the pattern on these wings. Just real small little squiggly black lines. Like, I mean, that's just crazy how there's so much pattern on just such a tiny little moth. Like, literally, this is how big the moth is compared to my fingers. That's what he looks like. He's just a little guy. He would just get squished by anybody else that thought he was just an annoying little moth. And these are the ones that you don't want to see because normally those kind are the ones that like get into your clothes and stuff. They're the little tiny ones you see flying around like in grocery stores and stuff. Those ones, of course, you want to squish. Here is a tiger moth. We have another little tiny guy. And then we've got this one here that's cool looking. And now we have Gadget in the background. But there is that box. Okay, so here are some more moths. And like I said before in the other, like at the very first of the video, that all of these have been found in Kansas. Sadly, this one used to be a really pretty color. It used to be yellow with pink. But when an insect gets, like a moth, when it gets its wings wet, the water really affects it. And you can see here that it just really damaged the wings. It shriveled them up. And what used to be a really gorgeous moth was ruined by rain. But I still kept it because it's the only one I've ever seen, only one I've ever caught in this area anyway. But here is a snowberry clearwing, and they look like hummingbirds when they fly. They literally sound like them too. They're really cool. They look like bees, and that is for their own protection, to keep predators like birds from actually trying to catch them, because they look like a bee. We have some more tiny moths over here. Here's a copper underwing. They're very pretty, a very auburn color. Got some here. This is an Osage Sphinx moth, that one there. Very pretty. This one here is cool, and I see these a lot, but they are pink. They're very pretty. They like to pollinate flowers. We have another Sphinx moth here. These are gorgeous. I believe they're called soy lichen moths or something like that, and they're very pretty. Here's another underwing. Some more Sphinx moths, which the Sphinx moths are these two guys here, and we have another tiger moth here. Then we've got a few more tiny moths. And this one's interesting because only on the forewings, which are the top wings, does it have patterns. Then on the hind wings, it's just brown. Very interesting. And this one here reminds me of a Reese's peanut butter cup because it's which you can't really see it here, but it is a kind of peanut butter color, and then it's brown as well, so it's cute. So anyway, that is this box here. Okay guys, so these are my butterfly ones, a butterfly box, and I'll show you a few. Like this one here is gorgeous. This is a wood nymph, and I love this one because it's so unique looking, and it's got blue and yellow, and then I think the hind wings look just like tree bark. Yeah, check this out. It looks like eyes. It's so cool. I just love these wood nymphs. They're really hard to catch in town. Normally you find them out in the country or in a wooded area because they like to hang out on trees. We have another underwing moth, and this is the first one I've ever seen that actually has black. Normally they're a colorful color, or they're like brown or auburn or gray, but this one is black, and that one's really unique. We have some hackberry imperiers. Actually, this one here is a hackberry. This is another little nymph butterfly, like the one I just showed you, but this one is a different species. And I can't remember if he's called like the little nymph or something like that. But that's what that one looks like. We've got a painted lady and a pink lady, and you can definitely tell the difference between these two. The pink lady is just a little smaller, and it has pink. As you can see here, very gorgeous moth, butterfly, and in really good condition. I don't know what it is about painted ladies, but I always have trouble spreading their wings. Here's what a painted lady looks like. Very similar, but bigger. There we go. We have a question mark, and I'll show you why it's called that. This is the fall form. The spring form will be a little bit lighter, and you, of course, will see them in spring. But a question mark will have a silver question mark right there on the hind wings. A comma, which has a little bit more like torn looking wings, will have a silver comma on the hind wing. And then we have some sulfur butterflies, which these guys are bad news to see on your vegetables because their caterpillars are the little green ones that get like on your peas, your broccoli, lettuce. They'll just eat all of your vegetables. They're real pain in the butts, but they're very pretty butterflies. Here we have skippers, which are these little guys here. These two are Delaware skippers. We have some sooty, dusty skippers, whichever, depending on where you live, they're just going to go by different names. This here is a checkered. I forgot the name of it. It's pretty much a checkered butterfly. I can't remember the exact name. I actually raised this one from a caterpillar, and you can see just by. Now, I'm not really sure if his antennas broke off from when he was flying around, or if they broke when I was pinning it, or if it was eaten, but sadly, he does not have his antennas. But he is a very gorgeous butterfly. Then we have some spring azure butterflies, which are these, and the females are the darker ones here. So as you can see, like this would be a female. This is the male. Very pretty, vibrant blues on the males. We got some velvet, or not velvet, but violet purples here on these ones. Very gorgeous. So anyway, that is this box. Okay, guys, so this is one of the few boxes that is my favorite box that I own, just because all the butterflies in here are so impressive, and there are a few moths mixed in. Like we have the Achman moth right here. I'm pretty sure is how it's pronounced, but or how it what its name is, I'm pretty sure. But this is what it looks like on the front, and then on the bottom, it looks like this, which isn't that awesome? It is orange and pink. I just love this moth. It is my favorite Sphinx moth that I own, aside from that other one that had the bright pink on it. Then we have tiger moths down here, which I raised this one, and the caterpillar, like, I did not even know that's what it was going to turn into, and this one actually almost escaped because it was outside. Here's what it looks like on the bottom. Just a simply gorgeous tiger moth. And I just love the wings. The wing patterns are really beautiful. And then this little moth here, he's a cutie. He's very cool looking. And then, like, this one here also is a favorite. It's very cool looking. This next one I actually caught in Missouri. This one here. Oops, that went in sideways. There we go. But yeah, this one I caught in Missouri, and it's cool looking. It's got very pale yellow and white, and then it looks like this. Got some orange on it on the underside. Very pretty moth. And then we have some more, another underwing moth. This is a Texas crescent, a checkered crescent moth. That's what, I mean, butterfly, that's what the other one was. But this is a Texas crescent. And normally they don't stray into Kansas, so it was interesting when I actually spotted a bunch of these, but aren't those beautiful? Like, there's a bunch out at the lake. And so I just caught one, and what was funny is when I got home, there's two of them in my backyard. So that made me laugh. But here is a male goatweed butterfly. And they're really cool because they look so much like dead leaves. And I hear Gadget hunting in the background. Here is a spring version. I believe this is a spring version because there's a summer and a spring version of the zebra swallowtail. And one will just have more blue on it. Let me flip this over so you can see just how beautiful these are. Like bright, bright red stripes. Sadly, the antennas were lost when I was catching it, which is very easy to do. Luckily, the tails are still here because swallowtails, that's like their most attractive feature aside from the colors, is the tails are just gorgeous. We have two cloudless sulfurs. I can't remember which one is the male, which one's the female, but I'm probably going to guess that this one here is the male just because he's smaller, but I don't know. I'll have to look. And here's what this one looks like. So you can see the difference between the two, where this one has clearly is marked with spots. Most of the time with moths and butterflies, the males are smaller, so that's why I'm leaning towards this one is probably a boy. We have a spangled fritillary, and this one is awesome because they are like shiny, as you can see on the bottom. So when they're flying, they're very noticeable, as you can see. And my cats are really wanting in here. Good grief. Very talkative tonight. And yeah, last but not least is my male Polyphemus moth. And this one I caught. He is very cool looking. He was on the side of a friend of mine's house out in the country. Here's what he looks like on the underneath side. And he is also in the silk moth family, like the Luna moth. As you can see here, he has no mouth. Or proboscis, I should say, which is the little tongue they use to pollinate flowers. As you can see here, he sadly does not have one where he is a silk moth. Oops. There we go. But I have a, that is my male that I have, and then I have a female as well, and I really like how one, the antennas, but the eyes on these moths, and the pinks are just gorgeous. So anyway, that is this box. Okay guys, so we have some more checkered and azure butterflies in here. What's interesting is I thought I only had one Texas crescent, but apparently I have this one, which is old, and it's very sadly beat up, probably by birds or something, trying to catch it, which normally is the most common reason they are beat up, is because they'll peck at the wings and stuff. We have a giant skipper that's right here, and it also has some silver on the bottom like that spangled fritillary did. Very pretty skipper. This one here is cool. I'm thinking it's this one, and it has green. Yeah, green on the hind wings. Very cool looking. I have one also that has like red, and I don't remember which one, if it's this one up here. Let me see. Nope, this is also another one that is green. I love the underwings on here. Like, you wouldn't think from looking on top, oh, it's just a black butterfly that's ugly. Nah, but when you look on the bottom, just gorgeous. Let me move those around 1 second. Okay, so here's what, and I thought I only had one bagworm moth, and here's another bagworm moth. I'm just going crazy. I can't remember what I got anymore. Let me see if this is, see, this is normally what a normal hair streak butterfly will look like on the bottom, and then these are also hair streaks that had the green on the underwings, but that is what a normal one would look like. And of course we have a male monarch, and we have some, now this is a cabbage white. This is an albino version of a female yellow sulfur. This is a non-albino version here. So you can see the difference between those two. And we have a small wood nymph, which this is probably a male, I'm assuming. And of course, gorgeous as ever on the hind wings. Then we have a tawny imperial, which is like the hackberry, only a different color. They both eat on the hackberry tree. So that is this box. Okay guys, so this box has mixed stuff in it. We've got true bugs, a walking stick, and a cicada. Now if you remember from the wasp box I showed you, the cicada killer, this is what cicadas look like. They're the ones that are in the trees in the summer that really chirp loudly at night. A lot of people like to call them locusts, but a locust is actually a grasshopper. This is a female walking stick or stick bug. The males will actually be thinner, and they'll have this appendage at the end that kind of looks like a little clamp, which is used for mating. Over here we have some true bugs, which are like beetles, but they're have soft shells, and like, you know, stink bugs, this is a never mind, I can't remember what that one is. It's a stink bug, but it has a specific name. Here is a toad bug, and the toad bug is one of the few, like, that I very first started catching when I started doing entomology, because they were so easy to find, and they literally look like little toads. Let me bring them over here so you can see them. Do this so you can see them better. But yeah, they have these little front legs, and that's what they catch their prey with, which are normally other insects or little minnows and stuff. So that's what they look like. Stick him back over here. There we go. Then of course we have the milkweed the milkweed bug. I don't know why, but around here people call them barcerier bugs. I'm not really sure where that name came from, but that's not what they're called. And I'll zoom in over here so you guys can see some of these. Here is a sycamore lace bug, and they are so tiny. They're not good to see on your trees just because they actually eat on the trees, but so tiny as in, like, literally this is how big they are. They're very small insects. So that is some of the true bugs. Okay guys, so in this box there's not much, but I'll tell you a little story about this female tiger swallowtail. And tiger swallowtails normally, because you'll see I have one, the males are very bright yellow. They have black stripes, the blues, and the like yellows and greens and stuff on the bottom. But this is a female. The females are normally bigger, and they are completely different looking from the male. It's crazy. But on the underneath side, she is very kind of similar. You have that reminiscence of the male from the kind of faded gray with the black stripes. But this female is the only one I've ever been able to catch. And my grandma actually caught it for me. And she actually grabbed it with her hand. Oh, it killed me so much. I was like, oh my gosh, you did what? I can't even believe that this part of the wing is still attached. She grabbed it with her hand while it was pollinating one of her rows of Sharons and put it in a box. And then she called me and told me she had it. And I was like, oh my gosh. So yeah, it used to have a thumbprint, but it's kind of gone away now. I'm not really sure how that happens, but yeah, it went away. So when the judge at entomology for 4-H, he was like, "What happened here?" And I told him the story, and he was just laughing. I was like, "Well, she didn't have a butterfly net. She didn't know how to catch it, so she just grabbed it." So yeah. Here is a buckeye butterfly, and this one I believe I raised because I've raised buckeyes before. And you can see this is what the underneath looks like. They're a very beautiful butterfly. Especially, they're like one of the few butterflies that you'll start to see in the like early summer. Very pretty. And we have another spangled butterfly down here, except I can't remember what this one's called. And this is what it looks like on the underneath side. Also has the shiny silver. A very pretty orangish brown butterfly. And then this is the female cabbage white butterfly. The other one that I showed you in the last box had two black dots on its wings. This is the female, and that one was the male. So anyway, that is this box. Okay guys, so here is another grasshopper box. And it's got, looks like pretty much all grasshoppers. There's no crickets or katydids in here. So I'll just show you the few that are in here. And the only grasshopper whose name I can remember, this is a Packard grasshopper. And I kind of just remember because like the Packers team, but yeah. So that is the grasshoppers in this box. And this one used to be really colorful. I used to love it, but like the hind legs here used to be blue. And like you can still kind of see some of the red there, but it's really just faded. Like grasshoppers are real bad about fading with their pigment and everything. This one here, it has a unique look to it. That the other grasshoppers, like this one here, the head is shaped different and everything. It's really cool. The antennas on this one are broader, as where those ones are thinner. So this one's pretty cool looking, a very thin body. So that's that box. Okay guys, so this is the box that has my black swallowtail in it, because I just remember when I opened it. And what happened here was I went to put the butterfly in this box, and I whacked the hind wing off, which I kept the hind wing because I'm going to be gluing it, which I might as well do after I'm done making this clip. But yeah, the poor thing, I whacked the hind wing off. I can glue it back on and fix it, but I just could not believe it. Like, when that happened, I just put the box down and just walked away because I was so mad at myself for what I had just done. This is a squash moth, and these, normally their caterpillars plague the squash plants and different things like squash, zucchini, cucumbers, like maybe a few of like watermelon, cantaloupe, you know, in the squash family and similar plants. Used to be a really pretty green and orange, but it's kind of faded a little bit. But that's that one, and it's really cool because where the hind wings are see-through, so that's cool. I don't know why my camera keeps doing that. Then we have a, let me think, because there's two. There's a tomato hornworm and there's a tobacco hornworm. And the only difference is the yellow spots on the abdomen. Two, four, five. So this one has five spots, so I'm pretty sure this is a tomato hornworm. The tobacco hornworm, I'm pretty, has 6 to 7 spots, I'm pretty sure. So that's, oh, sorry, my hand's in the way. That's one of the ways that you can tell the two apart, and this one is smaller than the tobacco hornworm. Here's a few beetles. We got some tortoise beetles. We got some blister beetles. We got a squash bug over here, which you don't want to see in your garden. Got some boll weevils here. That one, those ones. Another blister beetle. We've got a June bug is what they're called, which a chafer beetle is what those are actually called. And then we have a cucumber beetle, which is this one here. So pretty much all pest bugs right here. And then we've got, this is an aphid up against an aphid. And this aphid I actually caught in Oklahoma, and it is huge compared to this little aphid down here, which is his cousin that I caught in my garden. So you can see the difference in size there. And then we've got an obscured bird grasshopper. We have another Packard grasshopper. Another katydid here. This one hasn't faded like the last one I showed you, so you can still, oh, yep. Hold on. There we go. Had to loosen up the pin. But this one here hasn't faded, so you can still see the veins easy on the wings. Very cool looking. So that is this box. Okay guys, so I just want to show you real quick, this is how you fix a hind wing, which I'm getting ready to put some pins in here to hold up the wing so it can dry. But you just take a little bit of Elmer's glue, which I have right here, the back of it, so you can't really see the front of it. Just craft glue and you can glue the wing together. And I've done this a lot of times, so I know just like how to position it to make it look like it never fell off. I mean, aside from the glue blob being there, but just wanted to show you guys real quick, this is what it'd look like if it had its other wing attached. So, and a little trick that you can use glue to attach broken body parts. Okay, so this is what it would look like if it was to be splinted with the pins, and this already had a hole there in the wing, so I just put it there to hold it there. And it normally takes a good day for the glue to dry when it's a blob like that. So normally you'll wait till it is completely clear, because with Elmer's glue it turns clear when it's dry, and then you can remove the pins. So there's a little trick for you. Okay guys, so this is a display box that I took to a nature center that I volunteered at one time, so that's why there's a bunch of different insects in one box. And I have a few very impressive specimens in here, if I do say so myself. One of them, of course, is the very noticeable ash borer beetle, which is this one here. This thing is huge, and a friend of my dad's actually caught it. When I say huge, literally, like, here's how big it is compared to my hand. This is a very impressive beetle. Like, it's my favorite one of my all of my collection. It's just awesome looking. And it has, like, these horns on the prothorax, which is this part here in the middle, which is so cool looking. And then, I don't know if you saw last time because I forgot to mention this, but my other cicada, these are the ones that live 13 years and they only come up every 13 years. That's these ones here. And I actually was given a couple of those. This is the female. I was given a couple of them by a woman that came into the greenhouse I used to work at. I actually was able to talk her into giving me a couple because where I collected insects, she almost didn't want to. But she had like 5 of them. And I was like, you know, look, can I, you know, have a couple? They're going to be on display for people to enjoy. And she let me have a couple, so that was cool. Here is a very cool looking fly, and I cannot remember the name of it for the life of me, but this is a bee mimic fly of a sort, and it's a very ugly fly, as you can see here, but he's very unique in his body shape. And his whole body used to have the yellow, but it kind of faded. So who knows how long the other yellow is going to stay, hopefully a while. We have a Midas fly, I'm pretty sure is what this guy's called. We have a sweat bee, which these are really cool because they're a very pretty bluish green color. Very pretty looking bee. Put him back. We have an ant here. A flying ant. I'm pretty sure it's actually like a queen ant or something. I'm not really sure. But he's pretty cool. We have another Ichimon or a Chumen wasp here. We've got these. We've got a bumblebee. A thread-waisted wasp, I'm pretty sure is what that guy's called. Some beetles. We have another cedar. I can't remember the name of them now. I feel terrible. My brain. Okay, here's another longhorn beetle from like that one that I was telling you guys about earlier. This guy is tiny though compared to the other one I have. Actually, this is a thread-waisted wasp. I can't remember what this one's called. Got some beetles. Here's another longhorn beetle. This is my most gorgeous one that a friend actually gave me that she found out in the country. Got a longhorn beetle here. This one is really cool. I don't really remember its name. This has become like a thing apparently that I can't remember names. But there's just so many insects that after a few years it's just hard to remember them all. And then we have a ladybug, which this one, it was quite difficult. Let me fix this real quick. It's bugging me. Oh my gosh, that wasn't even meant to be a pun. This ladybug, it took quite a while to be able to spread its wings to make it look like it was in flight. Oops, sorry. Whacked that one. But here is what the ladybug looks like when it's in flight. Focus. There we go. I mean, even spreading the legs to make it look as if... Like, this is the fun that I can have, like, You can be serious about the collecting and teaching people about the insects, but you can have fun with it and make it look cool. This is a mantis fly, and it's in the lacewing family, but it looks like a praying mantis. This is the only one I have ever caught. Second one I've only ever seen in my entire life, and the other one I saw was green. And I thought it was a baby praying mantis, and I got home and I looked at my book and I was like, "What? That's a thing?" And I went back and it was gone. So, this one I actually found in my backyard and it was pretty cool. Here's a leaf-footed bug. He's a true bug. We have some moths here. Oh, Blossom, you're so sad. Then, of course, we have a few grasshoppers. This is the sword-bearing katydid, the female that I was telling you about that has the long optivisor or an ovipositor. As you can see here, it does look like a sword. It's a very cool looking katydid. And this brown one here is what they look like when they fade. These two are really old, and this one used to be bright green, and you can see it's starting to fade. This one's gotta be at least 5 years old. They're very old. And this grasshopper's cool because they actually don't grow wings. And that is the biggest one I have ever found. Like, normally they're about this big. Between here and here, that's about how big those grasshoppers normally are, and this is the biggest one I've ever found. It used to be green though, turned brown. It's a thing. So that is this box. Okay, guys, so here's a few more leaf hoppers and cicadas and stuff. So I'll show you real quick. Here are a few cicadas. This is a dog days cicada right there, and those are the most common ones that you'll see, is these ones. These two I've only ever saw, like, I think one other time, and these two I actually caught in a pool, like they were already dead. So I had to let them relax in my relaxation chamber for a week before I could actually move them, just because where they'd been in water. But I'll show you real quick how to tell a male and female cicada apart. Let me see. This one is a male, and you see these two round discs that are under his wings. They're these deals right there. Those are what he beats together to make the noises, and the females can actually not make a noise. The males have songs that they will sing in the, like, evening, and that's what you hear in the trees. The females, as you can see, lack those discs. The females cannot make a noise like the males can. So that's a way to tell them apart. I actually read that in a book. And we have a few leaf hoppers here with Blossom crying in the background. Oh my gosh. Really? Really? Can I help you? Really? Is that fascinating? I'm sorry, you can't come in. I'm doing bug stuff. No, you can't. You can't come in. You'll jump up and mess with my bugs. One time I had Roxanne jump up and she smashed one of my butterflies. Just smashed it with her paw. So yeah, ever since then, cats are not allowed in here. We have a ragweed leafhopper, which is this one here. This one is ragweed. The other ones I can't tell you because I can't remember. Because that's a thing, remember? So anyway, that is this box. Okay, guys, so this is the, of course, my display boxes are the wax boxes I have to put the moth crystals in. And I'll just show it to you real quick, this first one, before I say goodbye. Yeah, I pretty much went through, yeah, I went through two boxes of moth crystals. And I'll show you real quick. This is how much. This is how much it takes right here to do all those boxes. Like, that's two boxes worth, because I'm getting ready to use these last four from this box that I opened, and I already had one bag that was open, so I pretty much went through two boxes. So you're looking that if you have as much boxes, because, like, here are all my insect boxes here, and pretty sure there's 24 of them. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and change this out. I'll just show you a few, like, my other video I showed this better, so if you want to see it better, you'll just have to watch the other video. But yeah. This was my collection I did, and it has 350 insects altogether in this one and in the bottom one, which is like grasshoppers, crickets, praying mantises, stick bugs, stuff like that. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching, and I hope you have a good day.